last 3 weeks, ang una nating pinag-aralan sa tema ng Growing in Christ ay, kung naalala pa natin, it's about ano nga ba yun? Tungkol sa growing in love to Christ. So, maybe sabihin nun. Ang tanong ay, did our love grow after 3 weeks? Or just the same? So, whatever is the status of our love to Christ, it is known by the Lord, and the Lord wants us to grow in love to Him, not to anyone. Okay? So next topic is, to grow in Christ is to increase our faith. The next question is, after 2 weeks, kumusta na yung pananampalataya natin? How is our faith growing? Did we ask the Lord to grow our faith? Or we just ignore it? No. Good. Thank you for that reaction. Last after that is we study about sanctification progress. A Christian must or should progress in sanctification. Mm-hmm. It is not optional. Hindi po ito kung gusto ko lang. No, it is vital for us Christians to understand or to know our progress in sanctification. Sanctification is inseparable with justification. Because a Christian is justified, Jesus gave His life for us to be justified and for us to live a life being sanctified. So sapagkat ang ating Panginoong Hesus, binigay niya ang kanyang buhay, para tayo ay mapawalang sala, tayo naman ay magpatuloy na mabuhay bilang pinawalang sala or patuloy sa pagpapabanal or sa kabanalan. So yun po yung pangatlo. At ngayon, tayo ay titingnan natin yung title na nilagay ko ay Share Christ's Glory and Suffering. Ano nga ba ito? How it is supplement in our study, our monthly theme about growing in Christ. Paano nga ba ito makatulong sa ating kaunawaan? Paano lumago bilang isang Kristiyano? Or paano lumago bilang o paano lumago kay Kristo? Mahalaga po ito sa ating kaunawaan dahil ito ay sinasabi ng maliwanag sa Biblia. Tayo po ay manalangin. Let us pray. Father God, thank you so much for this time. Lord of all, thank you for thy mercy, thank you for thy grace that in the cross You have given us the pardon. Jesus, You have taken our sins. By believing in You, by repenting our sins, we are adopted as the children of God. Even though we are worthy to be punished because of our sins, You are punished at the cross of Calvary, and You paid, You atoned our sins that we might reconcile to God. And thank You that Your Holy Spirit Father Jesus will teach us today to savor your grace, your words, that we will be sharing the glory of Christ and even his suffering. And this is all we pray in your name, Jesus. Amen. Ayan. Marami po tayong mga verses na tingnan. At gusto ko pong ihanda ninyo at isulat yung ating mga versikulo. At gusto ko rin ilagay yung aking timer dahil para hindi tayo masyadong mag-overtime. Although ang marami ay willing naman lagi sa overtime. Yun. So handaan nyo po yung inyong mga notes, sa mga nagno-notes, sa mga nakikinig. Salamat. Handaan nyo rin ang inyong pakinig. At sa biyaya ng Panginoon, buksan lalo pa ang ating pandinig, ating mga puso para maintindihan ang isa sa mahalagang topic natin ngayon. Now, growing in Christ is sharing Christ's glory and suffering. Many Christians today, they don't like the word suffering. They just want the glory of Christ. Now, when we talk about Christ's glory, or sharing Christ's glory, first, we need to understand, kailangan nating maintindihan kung ano ang gloria or glory what we are talking about. First, we need to think Christ's glory in relation to His deity. Christ's glory in relation to His deity or being divine or being God. Okay? So, mahalaga po itong maunawaan natin. Now, we could not share the glory of Christ with regards to His Lord or Adonai or being God. Hindi po pwede yan. Hindi tayo magiging Diyos. So, hindi, when we think about sharing Christ's glory, we are not thinking about His being Son of God. We are Son of God by what? By adoption in Christ. But we will not be Son of God as if equal with God or the second person of the triune God. So, dapat maliwanag sa atin ito. Now, in Greek and in Hebrew, glory means kabod. In Greek, it is doxa, which is the word came doxology. We are giving glory to God. That's why I like the doxology hymn. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. So that yun yung doxa, we are giving glory, honor to God. Yeah. Okay? Kabod ay ibig sabihin or meaning glory and honor. The same word, doxa. Well, kabod can be associated with dignity, wealth, or high position. So, for example, His Highness. So, it is because He has or He had that position, that honor, that glory. Then there is a Greek word, doxa. The translation is the same, but there is additional splendor. So it is glory, honor, and splendor. So can be mean the same as kabod. Kapareho din halo siya ng kabod. Yan. Welcome po. Now, If we will look Psalms chapter 8 verse 5, na po tayo doon. If we will go to Psalms chapter 8 verse 5, God give what He gives. 8 verse 5, it says, "Yet you have made him a little lower than heavenly beings and crowned him with glory and honor." So God gave glory and honor to all or to His creations or creatures. So yun po yung glory or example about the glory we are talking about. Now again, sa ating lalong kaunawaan, ang nais natin makita, what we need to see is Christ's glory when He given Himself to us sinners. So but now we need to see first His glory being deity. Gusto muna natin makita ang kanyang pagiging divine, ang pagiging Diyos ni Kristo. Now, actually, I would like to suggest all of you that we are having a doctrinal study, I would say, or theological study. So now we are studying about the attributes of God. And later on, we will study about the doctrine of God in terms of Trinity. It is really a biblical. So we need to study. And then after that, we need to go to Christology. And hopefully, kapag nandito pa tayo with those days, we'll continue about soteriology and other more biblical teachings na dapat nating maintindihan. So we need to look at Christ's glory. In John chapter 17 verse 5, now, glory that relates or emphasize His deity. We need to look at first the glory of Christ in reference of being divine, being God. So in John chapter 17 verse 5, He prayed and He says, or He said, "Father," I'll look at in ESV version 17 verse 5, sabi rito, "And now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with what? With the glory that I had with you before the world existed." That is in ESV version. Now, Jesus is saying, glorify your name, Father, or be glorified for the glory that I had before He comes to the earth, bago pa siya pumunta sa lupa, siya ay may gloria na nalen. Siya ay Diyos. He is with the Father, enjoying the solitariness of God in heaven. The Father loved the Son. Jesus loved the Father. The Holy Spirit loved the Father and the Son. That's why the Holy Spirit is sent by the Father, is sent by Jesus Christ to minister us, to help us, to be with us. Because Jesus is the second person of the Godhead. Actually, my preaching today is just a library of meditation. That's why it's just a one-page paper. I would like to pour out my heart how I know the Lord and how I love Him. Now in what we call this, in Isaiah chapter 48 verse 2, "This is my name," the Lord said. Yahweh. What is it? Titingnan po ninyo. "I will not give to anyone my glory." Hindi ko ibibigay ang kaluwalhatian ng pagka-Diyos ko. "I will not give to anyone." Yahweh, the Lord, is referring to His deity. Okay, naintindihan na natin? It refers to His God, being God. Hindi niya pwedeng ipamigay ito sa iba. Diba? So, we or Jesus could not give His glory as God to any other. Now, be careful. There are a lot of churches, quote-unquote, or some preachers, they will tell you that we will be like Christ. Yes, we will be like Christ in a manner of holiness, but not in deity. Now, so many people saying that you will become like God, you will become God. No, we don't share that kind of... We don't believe that. We will like Christ, that means we are conformed to His image. We become holier than before. Kung ang kabanalan natin noong 2017 ay 80%, ngayon nagiging 81% na. Wow, praise the Lord, mayroong progress. Yan. That's amazing. Because to progress another percent, it is the work of the Holy Spirit for us to progress in holiness. And if you are progressing by yourself, that's not progress. Kunting ihip lang ng hangin yan. Full of emptiness. No. Now, we are talking about the glory of Christ in terms of what He has done for us. In terms of what He accomplished to us. We call it, I call it, our positional glory in Christ. Kung ano ang meron tayo kay Kristo, that's what we share with Him. That is our ultimate treasure. Yan yung ating pinakamainam na alin? Na kayamanan sa buhay na ito. Hindi lang sa buhay na ito, not only in this life, but the life to come. And that life is for eternity. Wow! That's my treasure. Throughout eternity, hindi ko kayang maisip, hindi ko kayang pagsawaan ang mayroong gloria ako kay Kristo. I hope na matamis ito sa inyong pakinig. I hope that it encourages our minds, our heart. And I pray that it will change our way of thinking. It encourages us, not only encourages, it instructs us, not only it instructs us, it propels us, it fuels us to keep on marching on despite of sufferings, because I have glory in Christ, with Christ, for Christ. Okay? Ayan. We're almost done. We have only 13 minutes already. So, now, the transcendent glory of Christ, we will not share that one. That is for Him alone. But what we called the positional glory, and we as Christians, we always ascribe the glory of God. We always giving Him glory. The ascribed glory of God. Of Christ. Being God, the ultimate glory of a person, of a human, is to what? I like the testimony 2 years ago. The only duty of man is to glorify, to give glory to God, to Christ. We could not give glory to God the Father unless we don't know who is Christ. when we give glory to Christ, we are giving glory to the Godhead, the triune God. That's sound biblical theology. So we are to ascribe glory. Westminster Confession of Faith, question number one. If you have that one, it says, what is the essence of a man or of a human? Ano ba ang kahalagan? Ano ba Tagalog yung essence? Sustansya? Ano ba yung essence? Yung... Anyway, the essence of a man. The answer is, the essence of a man is to be with God and enjoy with Him forever. Yes, rightly said. The essence of man is to be with God and enjoy with Him forever. In Hebrews chapter 1 verse 13, this is about Christ first. This is who is Christ. This is a little bit about Christology, about the deity of Christ. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 11, it says, He is the radiance of God's glory, the exact imprint of His nature. Jesus is the radiance of the glory of God. He is the image of God. Diba? We remember when Philip is saying, Lord, show us the Father, show us God. And Jesus said, Philip, I have been with you so long. What's up, man? Ikaw yata nakikinig sa Bible study natin, ha? Hindi naman ganun, ano? Kinaba. He's saying, look at me, Peter. Philip. Tingnan mo ako. Makita natin yon sa John chapter 14 verse. I think verse 8 to 9. Look at me, Philip. Look at me. If you see me, you see the Father. Wow. When we see Jesus in heaven, we see the Godhead dwells in Him. Correct? In Colossians chapter 1, verse 19, as we will go there for a little while. Yeah. Colossians chapter 1. We'll start in verse 15. Colossians chapter 1 verse 15. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For by Him, for by Christ, for by Jesus, all things were what? Created in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities. What? All things were created through Him and for Him. Verse 17. He is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. Verse 18. And He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from dead, that is everything He might be preeminent. Verse 19. For in Him all the fullness of God was pleased to dwell. Praise the Lord. So Jesus is saying, I am God. In Colossians, in Philippians chapter 1 verse 6, we'll start in verse 6. We need to understand about the glory of Christ as God, as the second person, so we can start sharing His glory, what He has done at the cross of Calvary. chapter 2 verse 6, sorry, in Philippians. Verse 6, it says, though he was in the form of God, he did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped. Verse 7, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of man. So Jesus, he is from the form of God. He become flesh when the Son is given and a child is to be born. In John chapter 1 verse 14, we'll see it. John chapter 1 verse 14, it says, how amazing God, how amazing is His grace. Wow, we sinners worthy to be punished, but now verse 14 it says, and the Word become flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen His glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, what? Full of grace and truth. The Father is full of grace and truth. And when we look at in Old Testament, John is saying, ha, nakita namin yung gloria na yan at ang katotohanan na yan. Nabuhay siya kasama namin. We have seen His glory. Because in John chapter 1 verse 1, it says, In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, through Christ. And without Him, without Christ, was not anything made that was made. So that's the deity of Christ. And we can talk it, we can discuss that one after some time. But now we are just looking at some biblical verses, how the Lord Jesus is equal with the Father. We can look also John chapter 10 verse 30. I and my Father are one. We can go to John chapter 8 verse 58. Before Abraham I was. When we go to John chapter 5, he is being tried to be put to death because he is claiming to be God. So a lot more verses we can look upon. I just want to one more verse in Titus chapter 2 verse 3. This is one of our favorite verse, I suppose. Of course, all the verses in the Bible is atin po itong mga paborito, di ba? Yan, salamat naman at paborito pala ang Biblia. The Bible becomes our favorite book. That's why we always go to the face of His book, right? Rather than the Facebook. Nagiging isang slogan na natin ito ngayon. Yes. Sometimes you ask the Lord, sorry Lord, we have a lot of time in Facebook rather than the face of your book. In Titus chapter 3 verse, sorry, chapter 2 verse 13, it says here, sinasabi po dito, awaiting for our blessed hope. Tayo ay naghihintay sa ating blessed hope. The appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ. The appearance of our great Jesus, who is God and our Savior. Wow! And we are just thinking about Christ is just something na kumpare natin or kaibigan natin. Yes, He is our friend, but He is our God friend. He is the God-man who is our friend. So we could not share that one. But what we can share is what He does for us. So I'll skip a lot of verses because my time is running out. Now, positional glory we have in Christ. Take note this one. A lot of verses, I just get some. So I hope na makot natin. Now, think about this. In Old Testament, we Gentiles, tayo mga hintil, tayo ay tinawag na mga far off. Tayo ay mga malayo sa Diyos. Ang mga Israelita, sila ay yung mga nearby. But thank the Lord, that is what we need to share in Christ. Because of Christ, because in Christ, tayo na mga malalayo ay nailapit or nilapit sa Diyos dahil kay Kristo. Yan, you need to read in Ephesians chapter 3, chapter 2 verse 13. So just write it down kung hindi po mabasa. Just in ESV it says here, but now Paul is saying to the church in Ephesians, sinasabi niya sa mga Kristiyano sa Ephesus, sabi niya, ngayon, but now, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far off have been brought near by the blood of Christ. That is the glory we have in Christ. Ako na malayo dati kay Kristo or sa Diyos, ngayon ay ano na, malapit na dahil kay Kristo, dahil sa kanyang dugo. Ako ay hinugasan, pinatawad sa aking kasalanan, na dati ako ay malayo sa Diyos, ngayon ay malapit na. How amazing that good news we have in Christ. Kaya ang Kristiyano, kumusta ka na? Ito, ganun pa rin. Runner, hindi ka ganun pa rin. Hindi ganun lang Kristiyano. Ang Kristiyano ang pinakamasaya kahit sa maraming problema because we are nearby, we are in God because of Christ. Wow! Yo, so we are, that's the glory we have in Christ, we are nearby, we are bring by Christ to God. We are reconciled. Mamaya magbigay pa tayo ng ilang sa Acts chapter 2 verse 39. Kaya medyo marami na itong verses na ating tingnan. Kaya hold on, keep on putting in your notes. Kasi maganda rin yung ituro kapag umuwi na kayo. You are going home in vacation and you want to teach your children. This is we have in Christ. Nothing more, nothing less. Keep on telling who is Christ. Chapter 2 verse 39 verse 2:39 in Acts, it says here, ito po yung sinasabi. Now, listen carefully. For the promise is for you and for your children and for all who are far off, everyone whom the Lord our God calls to Himself. Wow! Salamat po Panginoon dahil kasama ako sa mga malayo dati, na ngayon dahil tinawag mo yung mga malayo kay Kristo, ako ngayon ay malapit na sa inyo. That's what we need to share. Yan yung kaluwalhatian, mayroon tayo kay Kristo. Yan yung lagi natin ipinagmamalaki. That's why Paul is saying, I rejoice in the Lord. That's why Paul is saying, I boast only the cross. That's why Paul is saying, my glory is only Christ. Ang pwede ko pagmayabang ay ang ginawa lang ng Panginoon sa akin. So isa pa lamang po yun, nearby. Then we are reconciled. Colossians chapter 1 verse 20. Yan. So Colossians chapter 1 verse 20. It says here, verse 20. And through Him, through whom? through Jesus. The him there is, ang him po doon ay si Kristo. Nang dahil kay Kristo, sa pamagitan ni Kristo, and through him, through Christ, to reconcile himself all things, whether on earth or in heaven, making peace by the blood of his cross. Now, meron na po tayong reconciliation at meron na tayong kapayapaan sa Diyos na ating kalaban dati. We have peace with God because the reconciliation given by Christ. Wow! Hindi na tayo kaaway ng Diyos. Ito yung pansinin nyo. This is you need to think about. Kalabanin nyo na lahat ang pwede nyo kalabanin. Diba? But don't be the enemy of God. And thank God, when we are with peace with God, we have peace with our neighbors, with our mother and father, we have peace with everyone. We understand. I'll just run immediately in chapter 5 ng Romans about the peace of God. We have peace with God. Romans chapter 5 verse 1. Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, what happened? We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. And that is, we have peace with God, we are justified, we are reconciled. Wow! That's the glory we have in Christ. Yan po yung mga Kristiyano. That's why we will not cease to praise Him. That's why we are not ceasing to pray for Him, to ask for Him. That's why we keep on marching on, progressing our sanctification, because we have the glory of Christ. Wow. Romans chapter 3 verse 25. What Paul says about, or he said about reconciliation. Chapter 3 verse 25, it says here, what is, whom God put forward as a propitiation by His blood to be received by faith. This was to show God's righteousness, because in His divine forbearance He had passed over former sins. Actually, we need to start in verse 24. And are justified by grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. Wow! When we are redeemed, we are reconciled. God forbear. When we are reconciled, God removed the wrath to us. Imbis na tayo ay parusahan, inalis na ng Diyos sapagkat kinuha na ni Jesus yon. That is why I can share the glory of Christ, Lord. Woo! Salamat po, Panginoon. Hindi dahil sa aking mahusay na pagbabuhay Bible study. It's not because of my own power, but this is because of your grace. But this is because of your love. Thank you for being divine in your forbearance. Wow! Yun po yung magandaan sa maliwanag na teaching ng Biblia. Now, I will skip some of the verses because the time is very fast. But I want to look at Galatians chapter 3 verse 13. How we are reconciled in the Lord. Yan. So Paul is saying in Galatians how we can share His glory. So Galatians chapter 3 it says that verse 13, yan na. Christ redeem us from where? Christ redeem us. Redeem is purchase us. Purchase means He paid us. There is a penalty to be paid. So redeem is to give credit. Di ba? Christ redeem us from where? From the curse of the law by becoming curse of us, for it is written, curse everyone who hangs on the tree. Because we are purchased, tayo ay binili, tayo ay binayaran, sapagkat tayo po ay nasadla sa isang kalalagayan na hindi po tayo pwedeng makaalis. At ang makakaalis lamang dito, makakaalis lamang tayo kundi sa banal na dugo ng Panginoong Hesus, yun ang pinambayad niya kanino? Pinambayad niya sa Diyos Ama, dahil guys ng Diyos Ama na tayo ay ma-reconcile sa Kanya. At nangyari lamang ito nung tayo ay, it is happen when we have faith in Christ, realizing that I am a sinner worthy to be punished, worthy to be punished in hell for eternity because I rebel against the holy, holy, holy God. What a good news we have in Christ. That's the glory we have. Amen?
Amen.
Wow. Kaya mga Kristiyano, hindi. Christian could not always say, you know, later on I'll go to the church. I'm really tired. Wow. You are tired. Jesus never ceases to be tired. Even now, He keep on praying for us. And He is excited to be with Him forever and ever. I'm always excited every day to be with Him. Wow. Lord, You are keep on praying in heaven for me, for us. In John chapter 1 verse 2, actually there are more verses we can look at or look on. Romans chapter 5 verse 10, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verse 18, Colossians chapter 1 verse 22. Now, ito yung isang maganda. When we are reconciled, we are the children of God. We are called the Son of God. Come on. Think about this. Pag-isipan natin ito. Akala natin ganun lang kadali ito. Akala natin it is a common business sa universe na ito. No! It is one of glorious business of God He has done on the cross of Calvary. And I can always think about this. I am a son of God. Lord, thank You. Out of billions, Lord, I am one of them. I am one of the multitudes. Si John the Beloved, nung sinulat niyang Revelation, he said, I see people, multitudes, no one could number. Wow. Kasama ako doon sa when we are in heaven, we will be shocked. Ganito ba karaming tao dito? No one can number. And thank You, Lord, that I am one of them. Ako ay isa sa mga taga roon. Let us look at John chapter 1, verse 12. So amazing. So great we have in Christ. John chapter 1 verse 12. It says here, in his version again because that's the Bible, but all who did receive Him, that is, all who believe in Christ. Why they believe in Christ? They accept Him as Savior because they are children of wrath. And they realize that without Christ, they will be dead in their trespasses and sins. And this, John said, but all who receive him, Jesus, believe in his name, he give what? He give the right to become the children of God. Wow. Every people nowadays, they are fighting for the right. But they are not living what is right. Diba? So yun ang problema natin. Ayaw ko na yung refresh kasi lalong mahirapan. I will repeat this one. God give us the right to become children of God. Wow. Can someone raise their hand?